The 2020s are clearly going to be filled to the brim with sequels, prequels, and spin-offs. Beyond the tentpole hits and franchise stalwarts, however, there are a good few movies you just might not see coming. These are the sequels you probably had no idea were happening. They thought this day would never come, but it really does look like Ridley Scott is heading back to ancient Rome. Nearly 20 years after the original Gladiator hit theaters, Scott is finally making a sequel to the story of Maximus Decimus Meridius. Of course, old Maximus is busy walking through heaven's wheat fields, so what's the sequel actually going to be about? Well, according to producer Walter F. Parks, the film is set to take place about 25 to 30 years after the original ended. And according to The Hollywood Reporter, Part 2 will focus on Lucius, the son of Maximus's old flame Lucilla. While Spencer Treat Clark played Lucius in the first film, we don't know if he's going to reprise his role for Gladiator 2, but it doesn't seem likely. However, it does sound like Connie Nielsen, who played Lucilla, could come back. Speaking to Collider, Nielsen said that the sequel was still on the ledger, and when asked if she'd be willing to return as Lucilla, she said, "It would obviously be amazing, and I know that a lot of people want to see more of that."
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?
Peter Craig will be working on the screenplay, whose previous credits include The Town and the upcoming Top Gun sequel. And with Scott at the helm, you can bet your bottom dollar you'll at least be entertained. The Groundhog Day of alien invasion movies, Edge of Tomorrow is hands down one of the best sci-fi films in recent memory. Starring Tom Cruise and Emily Blunt, this Doug Liman flick focuses on a cowardly major who finds himself reliving the same day over and over. Unfortunately, said day revolves around a gruesome battle against an army of extraterrestrials dead set on conquering Earth. But while the film earned rave reviews on its release, it was a big disappointment at the box office. Coupled with an open and shut ending, it didn't really seem like Edge of Tomorrow would awaken from its box office death to find itself on theater screens yet again, but it looks like history is about to repeat itself. Edge of Tomorrow 2 is officially a go, and Tom Cruise, Emily Blunt, and director Doug Liman are all coming back. Probably, at least. Warner Brothers has tapped The Invention of Lying's Matthew Robinson to write the screenplay, and it sounds like the trio's return is dependent on the quality of that script. For his part, Liman seems pretty psyched about directing a sequel, and in the past, he's claimed Part 2 will be much better than the original film. Should a sequel take shape, Liman says it would likely be much smaller in scope, telling Collider, "I've always been interested in the idea of a sequel being more character-driven than the first film because that's not how things are normally done. That's been my approach when developing the sequel." Although rumor has it that Warner Brothers always wanted to make a third Sherlock Holmes film starring Robert Downey Jr., the actor's status as MCU poster boy for the last decade seems to have thrown things into disarray. Saving the world every couple of years is a draining gig, and Downey's superhero commitments have clearly kept him from being able to return to Sherlock Holmes for a third time. Now that Downey has finally exited the MCU for good, however, he finally has time to team up with Jude Law's Watson and solve one more case.
Most engaging.
The third Sherlock Holmes film will be helmed by Rocketman director Dexter Fletcher, a departure from the first two films, which were both directed by Guy Ritchie. The script, meanwhile, comes from Narcos creator Chris Brancato. While Sherlock Holmes 3 was originally scheduled to release on Christmas Day 2020, it's since been delayed due to the uncertainty caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. After having its theatrical release bumped from 2020 to December 21, 2021, Fletcher remarked in the fall of 2020 that it's sort of sitting on the back burner at the moment until it becomes clear where the world is at and what's going to happen. As such, it seems likely that the long-awaited Sherlock Holmes 3-quel may not hit its 2021 date either. Start your engines, because it sounds like a sequel to 2017's motor-tastic heist hit Baby Driver may eventually be zooming its way into production. Ansel Elgort, the star of the first film, mentioned in 2019 that he'd seen an early version of a sequel script and that he thought the film was indeed likely to happen. Edgar Wright himself confirmed in early 2021 that three drafts of the script had been completed, but that due to the COVID-19 pandemic, he wasn't sure what, if anything, the next steps might be. As for what the plot of a Baby Driver sequel would look like, Wright told Empire in 2017, With most sequels, you have to contrive something so they go back to square one, unless there's somewhere deeper for them to go. I sort of have an idea that if you did another one, you would subvert his involvement in the crime in a different way, so he's not the apprentice anymore. Unfortunately, following the sexual assault allegations levied against Elgort in 2020, it's unclear if Wright's original idea for the sequel will work, if he'll want to center it around Elgort's character at all, or if he'll decide to go in a different direction altogether. After six successful installments in the found footage horror franchise, Paranormal Activity is coming back with a seventh film, which will once again partner Paramount Studios with horror mega producer Jason Blum. The film will be helmed by underwater director Will Eubank, from a script by Happy Death Day scribe Christopher Landon, and after a bit of shuffling due to the COVID-19 pandemic, has settled on a release date of March 4th, 2022. No casting has yet been announced, and the studio is keeping the story details firmly under wraps. That said, every Paranormal Activity sequel has tied back to the original movie's characters in one way or another, and you can probably expect Paranormal Activity 7 to continue this trend, introducing a new group of characters doomed to have their lives ruined by crossing paths with Katie or her family. Keeping with the style of the first six films, it's also a certainty that the seventh Paranormal Activity will be presented as found footage recorded via security cameras, mobile devices, and other household recording equipment. That's kind of their thing. After the release of two so-so Tomb Raider films starring Angelina Jolie in 2001 and 2003, the franchise was rebooted in 2018 with Alicia Vikander taking on the lead role. Now, that new franchise is also getting a sequel, which was previously set to release March 19th, 2021, but was then delayed indefinitely due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Vikander is set to reprise her role as Lara Croft, but after originally tapping Ben Wheatley in 2019 to direct, the studio pivoted in early 2021 to announce that Tomb Raider 2 will be written and directed by Lovecraft Country showrunner Misha Green. Adapted from the popular Tomb Raider video game series, the first film follows adventurous archaeologist Lara Croft as she journeys into perilous locations in search of her missing father. Although little is known about the plot of the sequel, the first film set up one possible storyline, with its reveal that her father's former business partner, Anna Miller, heads up the very company that was set to release the world-ending virus that Croft prevented. The door is wide open for Miller to return in the sequel, stepping more fully into the role of a villain than she did in the first film. In 2015, Mad Max Fury Road reinvigorated the long-dormant Mad Max franchise, which first began in 1979 with Mel Gibson in the title role. Fury Road offered a new spin on the post-apocalyptic tale, casting Tom Hardy as Max and shifting focus to Charlize Theron's rage-fueled imperator, Furiosa. Mad Max Fury Road also wowed audiences and critics alike, with many considering it one of the best action films of all time, so it seemed that sequels would be inevitable.
Oh, what a day! What a lovely day!
And sure enough, two follow-up films are now in the works. One is a direct sequel, while the other is a prequel centered around a younger Furiosa. The sequel, which has been given the working title Mad Max: The Wasteland, was reportedly greenlit by Warner Brothers in early 2020 and will follow Hardy's Max Rockatansky, but won't feature the return of Furiosa. And while Furiosa will bring back the character, Theron herself won't be making an appearance in that film either. Director George Miller said that as much as he loved Theron's performance in Fury Road, he doesn't have enough faith in de-aging technology to allow Theron to reprise her role for the prequel. Instead, the younger Furiosa will be played by Anya Taylor-Joy, who will be joined by MCU star Chris Hemsworth and Emmy-winning Watchmen actor Yahya Abdul-Mateen II. Furiosa will be tearing into theaters on June 23, 2023. After six main Rocky movies and two Creed spin-offs, MGM may finally be making an installment in the Rocky franchise without Rocky himself. Although the studio has hired writer Zach Bailyn to pen a third Creed film, Sylvester Stallone went on the record after Creed II claiming that he was done playing Rocky Balboa for good. Granted, there's still plenty of story to explore, even without Rocky, with Michael B. Jordan's character Adonis Creed ending the second movie not only a victor in the boxing ring, but also a father of a baby girl with his fiancée Bianca. Little else is known about the plot of the third Creed film, including whether it will continue to follow the same formula as the Rocky films on which it's based. But one thing is for sure, in addition to starring in the film, Jordan will be making his directorial debut with Creed III, saying in a statement, "This franchise, and in particular the themes of Creed III, are deeply personal to me. I look forward to sharing the next chapter of Adonis Creed's story with the awesome responsibility of being its director and namesake." Creed III will arrive in theaters on November 23rd, 2022. When the Keanu Reeves-led samurai fantasy 47 Ronin hit theaters in 2013, it didn't exactly blow anyone away. Not only were the reviews largely negative, but it failed to earn back its $175 million budget, making it one of the biggest box office bombs of 2013. Between the disappointing critical response and the lack of commercial success, it didn't turn out to be the kind of film that typically gets a sequel. Nonetheless, in August 2020, it was revealed that a new 47 Ronin adventure is on deck at Universal and will be headed straight to Netflix. The sequel will be directed by Mulan star Ron Yuan. Of the film, Yuan said, "I'm incredibly excited to be working with Universal and the producing team on this genre-blending, martial arts, action, horror, and cyberpunk film. This will be a fun, intense, supercharged thrill ride for viewers globally." The original movie told a fictionalized account of the real-life 47 Ronin, a group of 18th-century samurai who set out to avenge the death of their master. The film added a fantasy element to the story too, setting the character's quest in a world filled with magic, witches, and dragons. Right now, there's been no word on whether Reeves or the other stars of 47 Ronin will be returning for the sequel. However, based on Yuan's statement that the new film will be cyberpunk, it sounds like it'll be set in the far-flung future rather than the distant past. So don't go holding out for an appearance from Reeves and company. While Hocus Pocus failed to make much of a splash when it was first released in 1993, it has since gathered a significant following as a Halloween staple, with more and more fans discovering the witchy joys of the Sanderson sisters each and every year. The film follows a group of kids who accidentally resurrect the Sandersons on Halloween, 300 years after their execution in 1693. The sisters then set out to claim the souls of every child in Salem unless the kids who resurrected them can put an end to their antics once and for all. While details on the sequel remain scarce, original Hocus Pocus stars Bette Midler, Kathy Najimy, and Sarah Jessica Parker are set to return in the sequel, which will debut on Disney+. As Midler told Fox 5 News,
"They want to make a movie. They've asked us if we were interested, and of course all of us said, yeah."
Sadly, the original Hocus Pocus creative team of screenwriter Mick Garris and director Kenny Ortega won't be returning for the sequel, but Garris says he has every confidence in new director Adam Shankman to do the story justice. And Ortega gives the sequel his blessing too, telling Digital Spy, "I wish everyone all the luck in the world, however they're going to move forward with it. I hope that it's as fun and as successful for them as it has been for us." As bizarre movie premises go, it doesn't get much weirder than the original Face-Off. This 1997 action flick starred Nicolas Cage and John Travolta as a terrorist and an FBI agent, respectively, who literally swap faces via a gnarly surgery in order to each take the other's place. Yet, even though the first movie seemed to have a fairly straightforward ending, a direct sequel is now in the works from Adam Wingard and Simon Barrett. While original reports assumed that the new Face-Off film would be a reboot with a totally new cast taking on the story, Barrett and Wingard were quick to clarify on social media that they had no intention of reimagining the original. Wingard and Barrett have previously worked together on pulse-pounding films such as Your Next and The Guest, suggesting they're more than capable of taking on the violently wacky tone of a Face-Off sequel. Of course, with the villainous Caster Troy dead at the end of the first film, bringing back the original stars could be a little tricky. On the other hand, there's no rule that either Cage or Travolta would have to play their original characters in order to return, especially in a film that's basically all about people wearing faces that don't belong to them. In our current age of sequels, remakes, and reboots, revisiting one of the most iconic horror films of all time was all but inevitable. And sure enough, a new Exorcist film is in the works from Fright Factory Blumhouse Productions. David Gordon Green, who most recently wrote and directed the new Halloween trilogy for the studio, is in talks to direct, although no writer is yet attached to the project. The original Exorcist follows a 12-year-old girl who is possessed by a demon, leading her mother to hire two priests to perform an exorcism. And although that might not sound all that terrifying, The Exorcist was scary and gruesome enough to attract a ton of controversy back in 1973, and it has since gone on to become one of the most iconic horror flicks of all time. Over the years, The Exorcist franchise has also spawned 4 film sequels as well as a TV series, but it's not yet clear which of these storylines, if any, will be incorporated into the new sequel.
Manners maketh man.
Although the Kingsman prequel, The Kingsman, keeps getting pushed back due to the COVID-19 pandemic, that hasn't stopped the studio behind the edgy action franchise from looking far into the future of the series. Marv, the production company responsible for the Kingsman films, is making ambitious plans for a whopping 7 more installments. A tall order by any measure, but especially considering the second film was much more poorly received than the first. Still, the franchise has already built in plenty of room for more storytelling. While the first two Kingsman films starred Taron Egerton as newly minted British secret agent Eggsy, The Kingsman is a prequel focused on the early days of the Kingsman agency. So it seems likely that many of these upcoming movies will be prequels or spin-offs following other characters, rather than direct sequels focused on Eggsy himself. That said, rumor has it that there is a third Eggsy-centric film in the works, possibly titled Kingsman: The Blue Blood, as well as a spin-off focused on the American counterparts to the Kingsman introduced in the second film titled Statesman. No release is yet scheduled for either of these films, nor any of the others, but it looks like we can expect plenty of Kingsman adventures for years to come. Following the successful reboot of the Halloween franchise in 2018, with a film that served as a direct sequel to the 1978 movie, writer Danny McBride confirmed that another sequel was underway. Originally, the plan was to film two sequels back-to-back, releasing them a year apart. Halloween Kills was scheduled for October 16, 2020, and Halloween Ends would have concluded the series on October 15, 2021. However, several wrenches were thrown into the works. The ambitious shooting schedule wound up being too much to pull off, resulting in the filming of Halloween Kills wrapping up with no start date for Halloween Ends on the calendar. And then the COVID-19 pandemic bumped both films back a year, so that Halloween Kills will now hit theaters on October 15th, 2021, while Halloween Ends will debut on October 14th, 2022. Star Andy Matichak promises that Halloween Kills will be worth the long wait, though. Speaking to Bloody Disgusting's The Boo Crew, Matichak said, "It is a movie that I think fans will be very happy with. It's big, and it's bad, and it's mean." And we see Michael. I think Laurie, Allison, and Karen pissed him off a little bit by locking him in the basement because his retaliation is next level. Of course, she's referring to the end of 2018's Halloween, in which the three female leads locked killer Michael Myers in a basement and burned the house down around him. No wonder he's annoyed. Despite the better part of 4 decades having passed since The Last Starfighter first wowed audiences, the time may actually be ideal for a sequel to hit theaters. The first movie follows a teenager who beats a video game, only to discover that the game is really a recruiting tool made to find soldiers to fight in an interstellar alien war. Of course, video games have changed a lot since then, which could present a natural way to continue the story. Speaking to Moviehole about the sequel, Jonathan Batchul, the original film's writer, said, "It's not a remake, it's going to continue the story. What's changed is time itself. Certainly as the video world and the alien world have continued to tick away, it's not a time capsule of the 80s by any means. We're taking it to the next level, passing the torch, or the joystick." Batchul will be co-writing The Last Starfighter 2 with Rogue One screenwriter Gary Whitta. According to Batchul, the road to making a sequel has been a rocky one, but he's optimistic that the project will finally get off the ground. He told Moviehole in 2020, "It looks like we'll be making the deal to get it going. Gary's a gifted collaborator. We'll be writing the script together, but it's taken a long time. I had to go through a process that took years to recapture the rights, but that was recently completed, and although nothing is ever clear sailing, it looks like we have a really good opportunity now. So I'm really looking forward to taking it up." Yet another franchise that's endured for decades, the first Predator film tore into theaters in 1987, starring Arnold Schwarzenegger, Carl Weathers, and Jesse Ventura, and now a fifth film is on the horizon. The most recent installment, 2018's The Predator, was directed by Shane Black, and, well, it was hardly a critical success, currently sitting at a dismal 33% on Rotten Tomatoes. But it still made enough money at the box office to justify yet another sequel.
Only in the hottest years this happens. And this year it grows hot.
Predator 5 will be helmed by 10 Cloverfield Lane director Dan Trachtenberg, from a script written by Patrick Aysen. Each Predator installment thus far has focused on groups of people being hunted by a race of alien trophy hunters. Originally, the fifth Predator film was announced as a movie called Skulls, and the plot was said to follow a Comanche woman who disobeys her tribe's traditions to become a warrior. Later, Trachtenberg confirmed that Skulls was indeed a fifth Predator film, but he'd intended to keep that reveal a surprise before the news was leaked by Deadline. Still, even if the reveal didn't go as he planned, here's hoping the fifth Predator film will have enough shocks and thrills to make up for it. Even after a lackluster third film, which fumbled its surprise launch in 2018, the Cloverfield franchise apparently still has enough goodwill and potential to earn itself yet another follow-up. A fourth Cloverfield movie was announced in January 2021 from producer J.J. Abrams, who's hired Jiri Hadji creator Joe Barton to pen the script. Although the first Cloverfield was filmed as a found footage story following a group of young people in New York City fleeing an extraterrestrial monster attack, subsequent films have abandoned the found footage device. It appears that the fourth film will be no exception. Thus far, each Cloverfield movie has been relatively self-contained, each following a different cast of characters in a totally different type of storyline, all set within the same universe. The first film was a kind of urban monster film, while the second was a claustrophobic psychological thriller, and the third was a straight-up sci-fi horror. There's no telling what the fourth film will look like, other than that it will almost certainly tie in the same monster invasion that has appeared in each of the Cloverfield films so far. Cloverfield 4 stands out in one other regard, too. The second and third films were originally developed as standalone features and then retrofitted into the Cloverfield universe. This one, however, will be the first sequel designed with the franchise in mind, meaning the ties to the rest of the franchise could be much more pronounced this time around. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre films have been staples of the American horror canon ever since the first movie was released in 1974, and the years since have seen the release of seven sequels, comics, and even a video game adaptation. Now a ninth Texas Chainsaw Massacre film is in the works from director David Blue Garcia and writer Chris Thomas Devlin. This film will be a direct sequel to the original film, but it will be set many years later, with the cannibalistic serial killer Leatherface now an old man. The newest Texas Chainsaw Massacre film will feature an ensemble cast led by Nell Hudson and Elsie Fisher. But arguably, the most important returning face is Marilyn Burns, who played Sally in three of the other installments in the franchise, including the original movie. While the details of the plot are still under wraps, producer Fede Alvarez told Bloody Disgusting that fans of the original can expect the sequel to pay homage to the 1974 film in more than just its story. Speaking about the movie's use of practical effects, Alvarez said, "Everything is classic, old-school gags, never VFX. It's a very old-school approach to filmmaking. It's very similar to the original film." While no official release date has been announced, the film's official website says to expect the Texas Chainsaw Massacre sometime in 2021. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite movies are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.